why he is such an iconic character, and of all the great characters that genre has given us, he's one that seems to speak to people who aren't necessarily even normally huge fans of the genre.
Yeah, well, it's a good film, first of all. It's we have the music of Philip Glass, we have the cinematography of Tony Richmond, who did The Man Fell to Earth. We got Bernard Rose, who, I mean, you got Virginia Madsen, who's an incredible leading lady. It's just, it's iconic because it captures that particular side of Chicago before the fall of Cabrini Green. Cabrini Green is no longer standing. So, you know, it's a personal hieroglyphic that's left an imprint in the minds of people that I'm proud of. But I, yes, the conversation always returns to Candyman. I'm proud of him. Do I want that to be the only thing that people remember? Not at all. It's part of a package. And, you know, and he's been good to me. But he's not the only thing that I am. In some quarters, horror has a stigmatized, you know, opinion that is somewhat of a bastard child. So they should know that it's actually classier than most. That he's not a slasher, there's no teenagers in the woods. It's, you know, it's thought-provoking, and maybe it'll come away with a deeper understanding of this particular man in that particular situation and why he's after what he's after, you know, why he's trying to reclaim his dignity.